Well, out in the country, we didn't have mortuaries, and so it was always customary for the undertaker to do his job and lay your kin out right there at home. Yeah, and the church would loan you folding chairs, and you'd have visitation and everything right there. But when the nighttime come, you'd have to sit up with the dead, 'cause it wasn't right to leave them alone. Well, the last time I sat up was 65, when my old arthritic Uncle Fred died. He was 97, and so stooped over, the mortician couldn't straighten him out. They used a log and chain to hold him down. Covered that all up with a cape and a gown, and didn't tell nobody in the family, 'cause that's the kind of stuff folks just don't want to know about. Well, we were all sitting there, it was 3 in the morning, and then there come up a cloud of thunder, lightning and storming. Well, that lightning flashed and that thunder clapped, and that chain round old Uncle Fred went snap, rattled and fell to the floor with a thump, and Uncle Fred just sat right up. Yeah! And I ain't sitting up with the dead no more. I don't know about you. No, I ain't sitting up with the dead no more. No matter what you say or do. They say the dead can't hurt you, 'cause they already left. But what they left can sure make you hurt yourself. And I ain't sitting up with the dead no more since the dead started sitting up too. Lord have mercy. Well, when Uncle Fred sat up, so did everyone there. And there came a great parting of the folding chairs, and that preacher nearly knocked me down. He said, oh, I'm heading out that kitchen door. I hollered, Reb, that kitchen ain't got no door in it. He said, don't worry, son, it will have in a minute. And I ain't never seen so much jumping and shoving before. And then somebody stepped on old cat's tail. He let out a scream, a screech, a wail. And to say the least, that howl didn't help to calm the situation down. And then that lightning flashed and that house went black. And I spoke to my feet, so I said, boys, make tracks. And I went through that screen door, licking his split for town. Whoa. Well, I cut through the cemetery, fell in a hole. It was Uncle Fred's grave, and it was dark and cold. Yeah, the town drunk dug it, and he dug it too deep. And unbeknownst to me, he's still in there asleep. And I'm scratching and jumping, trying to get out of that hole. And he woke up and said, you might as well come over here and sit down beside me, boy, 'cause you ain't getting out of here tonight.
But I did.
Sitting up with the dead no more. I don't know about you.
No, I ain't sitting up with the dead no more.
No matter what you say or do. They say the dead can't hurt you, 'cause they already left. But what they left can sure make you hurt yourself. And I ain't sitting up with the dead no more since the dead started sitting up too. Wasn't no sense in nobody sitting up with Uncle Fred anyhow. Uncle Fred done been gonna sit up with his own self. Next time, I'm just gonna send flowers.